If you're new to Adobe Premiere, you might be frustrated to find that you can't just click File and then Save As to save your new video clip as the format of your choice. That is only giving you the option to save the project. To create our new video clip in the format of our choice, click on the File menu, and then select Export. We want to click the Media link, but it's currently grayed out. If you find Media grayed out, click within the Sequence pane to select it so it's surrounded in gold. With it selected, again click File menu, Export, and now select Media. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-M. The Export Settings window will open. The left pane of the window shows the video clip to be exported. Just as when working within Adobe Premiere, we can move through the video clip using the timeline under the video. For the source range, we have several options. We can select Entire Sequence, Work Area, or Custom. Entire Sequence exports the entire video clip from the beginning to the end. Work Area exports the selected work area from the Premiere project. This is not necessarily the entire clip. Custom exports a portion of the video clip that you select. If we only wanted to export a portion of this video, we could drag the beginning and end time markers that show up as gray triangles. Currently, they show up at the very beginning and at the very end, selecting the entire time sequence. Let's move the end time marker so that it only exports about 1 minute of this video. If we export now, it will only export this small portion of the video that shows up between the two gray triangles in gold. Currently, the time marker is showing up about halfway through the clip that we're going to export at about 34 seconds. The right side of the window shows the export settings that will be used to create our new video. The first thing we need to do is determine what format we're going to convert our video into. If you aren't sure what video format to use, I would highly recommend using the H.264 codec to encode your video files into MP4 files. MP4 files are pretty much the de facto high-definition video standard of the web today. Files encoded using an H.264 codec in an M4P4 container file offer very high quality audio and video while remaining relatively small in size. Blu-ray players use the H.264 codec because of these advantages. Let's click the drop-down menu next to Format. This is the list of available formats you can export the video into. In looking through the list, you'll notice video formats like H.264, MPEG-2, and AVI. But you may also notice audio-only formats like MP3 and WAV. If you only want the audio portion from a video clip, you can simply select an audio-only format here and save it. We want to create an H.264 format file, so we will click to select H.264. Let's click the drop-down menu next to Preset. Here we can see a list of pre-configured presets for video quality settings. Here are our custom settings for iPod and iPad size screens, TiVo, Vimeo, YouTube, and regular HDTV presets, among others. If you prefer, you can also create a custom preset. To get the best quality final product, it's best to output your video file at the same resolution that it was recorded at. This is a full HD video clip, so we're going to start out by selecting a preset out of the HDTV set. Let's select this HD 1080p 29.97 to start with. This will create a very high quality final product, but it will also create a very large file. If we look by the estimated file size, this 1 minute that we're going to export here is going to be about 233 megabytes. Now by selecting the preset we did, we chose it to use basic video and audio parameters. Among these, because it's full HD at 1080p, it's using a video resolution, width of 1920 pixels, and a height of 1080 pixels. We also select a video rate of 29.97 frames per second. Now if we scroll down a little bit, we can see the bitrate settings. A higher number makes the quality higher and the size larger. Currently it's set on 32 megabits per second minimum and a maximum of 40 megabits per second, which is huge. Let's drop this down so that we're not using up unneeded space on our computer. Let's change the target bitrate from the high number that it is now down to 5. And let's change the maximum bitrate to 8. This will give us a high-quality final product that is of a more reasonable size. We can now see that this 1-minute video clip, instead of being 233 megabytes, will now only be 37 megabytes, but the quality will still be very good. You can adjust the bitrate until you are satisfied with the size of the file. The minimum I would go is 0.7 for the target bitrate and 1.2 for the maximum bitrate. Let's select the name and location to save the new file. We do this next to the output name. There's currently a name listed. If we click on this, it'll bring up a save window. Let's simply select the location. This is just a test. Click the save button. And we can now see that it's going to output as save.mp4 into the folder that we selected. The last thing that we're going to look at is bitrate encoding. Currently it's set to VBR 1-pass. This means it's going to encode the file using a variable bitrate on the fly as it scans it one time or one pass. To increase the quality of the exported video, we can change this to VBR 2-pass. VBR 2-pass means that it will encode the video using a variable bitrate, where it scans the file on the first pass, and then uses that data to fine-tune the variability of the bitrate on the second pass. This will make the final video quality better, but will make it take much longer to render. Now that we have everything set up correctly, let's export the video clip. We have two options to export the video. The Export button. This will export the video and render it using Adobe Premiere. This will make Adobe Premiere unusable while the video is exporting. If you click Export, it will immediately begin to export the clip. Then there's the Queue button. This will export the job to the Adobe Media Encoder. You need to have Adobe Media Encoder installed for this to work, but it's included with CS6. If you export this to Media Encoder, then you can continue to work with Premiere while the video is exporting to the new format. This is the method that I use. Let's click the Queue button. The Adobe Media Encoder window will open. We'll see the video that we're exporting here. In this case, our name is Jag Sunsets, with the date. We can see that it's an H.264 codec, using custom settings, and we can see the output file path and name. We've already set up all our export settings, but if we wanted, we could change them by clicking on the custom link. This just opens back up the export settings window, and we can go through and change our settings if we would like. If we're happy with our settings, and we are, we can begin to export the file by clicking the Start Queue button, which is this little green arrow. At any point, if we like, we can click the Pause button. We'll see under Current Encode it shows a preview of the video, the processing setup and the elapsed time, and estimated time remaining. We can also see at the bottom a list of the currently set export settings like bitrate, frame rate, and so on. depending on the speed of your system and the settings that you set for the length of the video, the time it will take to render this will vary. As you can see if you look over in the top right-hand corner, I have an 8-core system and all the cores are pretty much maxed out. This is only a 1-minute video clip, and we're keeping it at the same resolution, just lowering the bitrate a bit. And it's expected to take about 6 minutes to do that 30 seconds. To open the output folder, we can just click on the video, and it will reveal the folder. This is our converted video clip in MP4 format. You should now have the necessary information to be able to export a video from Adobe Premiere CS6.